So there are quite a few new festivals coming up in the next few months. The next one is on the 19th of November. It will be held at Tito's, Festival of Sharing. So let's see, it's a challenge. Let's see how many Goans will volunteer to share their knowledge, skills. Could be arts, music, theater. Following that festival, the next festival will be Musganche Fest. Musganche Fest in the village of Nue at Carmel College with approximately 700 girls. That festival would be a heritage festival of our music. One of the oldest instruments in the world, the gumot, the mandale, will play the key role down there with our music, folk music, mandos, dulpots, and old songs. December 28th will be a new festival, Tornatanche Fest, Fest for the Youth of Goa. We will try to get young people to volunteer for that festival. So young role models will create. We're looking for volunteers from all around Goa that day for the Tornatanche Fest. Then I'm hoping and planning to do a festival in January called Joelache Fest. Joel Amso Amik is no more, but his work cannot be forgotten. Tremendous amount of work is on the internet, YouTube. So we will see if his friends from the press, Konkani, Mogis, and all of us get together and celebrate his work. We are looking for a venue possibly at Asagao or Mapsa. So, Joelache Fest, Yopache, Aha, Goya.
Asagao is there.
Yeah, so we'll see. Basically, people have to volunteer, they have to give us tables, they have to give us chairs, there are sound system. So, this festival is about sharing. So all these festivals, there are three and possibly a few more. And included is coming on the 9th of November. We are organizing a tour to Dibar Island. Basically, what's happening is Don Bosco's college have got a three-year course in travel and tourism. After 3 years of the course, what happens to the kids? Possibly they go and work in hotels, I don't know. But we are giving them another avenue that they can be guides, self-certified guides, but with their own resources. So Dibar Island, we've already taken them on a tour. I showed them about 30 different spots in Dibar. They chose 10. We went to the library, central library, and basically those 10 places, we found out new information. And coming on the 9th, we're going to be taking 30 students from Dempe College. So Don Boscos are the tour guides. Dempe College will be the students, the tourists. We will be going to Dibar, start at 9 o'clock. We'll be visiting those 10 venues. We will enter 3 houses in Dibar so the students can interact. 2 of them are returnees from abroad. Basically, ask them, why have you come back? You could have gone to New York, America, Germany, but why have you come home? What are the advantages of living in Dibar? There will be a person who's going to monitor all us. Us will be Prajal Sakadande. He's an historian. And our friend, my friend from the UK, who holds a blue badge in tour guides for London, he'll be coming with us for the whole tour. And at the end of the tour, he will be giving suggestions as a tourist from Europe, what he liked, and if we could improve. And the good news is already out of the 30 students that we've taken on the first tour last month have already been offered jobs around Goa as tour guides. So these are specialist tour guides. So soon in the future, if we can get help from people in IT and the digital world, we could create a platform for tour guides in Goa. So anybody coming from around the world could actually get in touch and saying, next month I'm coming to Goa with 10 people, can you take me to Chinchini?
Maybe an app or something of that.
Yeah, we will have to create. So you can take them to Chinchini. Now,
I could put you in touch with someone. Maybe.
Yeah, so we will do. I mean, so now the time has arrived because we have got the guides who have been trained. They are literate guides. So what would this guide do? Take you to a village. They will take you to somebody's home to eat real Goan food, introduce you to homestays in the villages. And other things can follow, like even things like if a Goan is returning home for 2 weeks at Christmas, he wants to repair his houses, he's looking for a carpenter, a plumber, somebody for the roof. These tour guides could arrange because they are from the village. So anyway, all these exciting things are happening, but we need help. There are people from different fields to get together because these are young people. These are 20, 22 year olds. And we made a good start. So the next tour is on the 9th of November. So follow us on Facebook. We will be there.
How many festivals so far and what's the range?
Okay, so we are nearing 32 festivals around Goa. Some are well known, some are famous, some are. Some villages do not want outside people to come because they want to keep it local. So we start from Karmana to Saligaon, from Arambol to Sukur, Pomorpa to other places. So we're going now, traveling all over. One of the things is people have understood the idea behind the festival. And we always start these festivals with no money. The base is no money. And if you don't need money, then you don't need a chief guest. If you don't need chief guests, you don't need sponsors. And after we don't need sponsors, then there are no prizes, then no competition. But the end product is you get bonding, you get networking, and you transfer skills from the elders, 70-year-olds, to the young generation. So out of that has come the Gumot is back, Suri Chai Pao is back, Molla making is back.
Suri Chai Pao is a traditional bread.
Bread made of toddy, coconut toddy. Now at the latest Poderanche Fest, that brought bread was brought back. So we've got the skills now. We know where to source the sur. And we know the baker who can make it is a young baker who learned the skills from an older baker.
And the Gumot came back because of the goat skin?
Yeah, and besides that, we did an awareness festival in April at Shirida, Gumtanje Fest. And my son Ashley Fernandez had done some research of it. And you need willing people, so we were lucky to get a willing potter who was willing to change the shape of the Gumot. So we had a traditional big Gumot. Now we made one smaller slightly for women, and another size for children. So in the last 3 months, about 10,000 Gumots have been sold. Some have gone abroad. People have come personally and reached Australia, the USA, the Gulf, England. So the Gumots now have got wings because it being legal with the goat skin can now fly. The monitor lizard had kept it stuck since 1972.
And the sound is comparable?
Yeah, so that sound and all that is for the future generations to work. If we worry about the sound, the maker will be finished. So we will make sound, but we won't actually have the maker of the pot. So our worry now today is how to help the potter survive. Once we get pots, our children in future will do sound engineering courses and come up with a sustainable solution. So the news is good. Things are happening. And
which is your most successful fest so far?
So success-wise is the Poderanche Fest. Because now people have all of a sudden realized that these are Goan bread. In future, in the past we've been talking about French bread, British bread, sliced bread, but we forgot Amche Goan Chai Pao, Poi, Kankana. So these are our bread, and these breads really need to be in five-star hotels. It needs to be in the shops. We have to be talking about our bread. This is our heritage. So that has been understood, and the Suri Chai Pao is another thing, which is, if somebody can take up as a startup, is a huge money earner. Because at that festival, we did a trial, so that was sold at 10 rupees each. But the demand was so much, the next day we made it 20 rupees. Still we couldn't cope with the demand, then it was made 30 rupees, and still we couldn't cope. So there's nostalgia attached to our breads, which needs to be transferred to the five-star hotels. You know, instead of them selling foreign breads, time has come to sell our local breads. So you would have like Sanna with Sarpotel, Choris with Pao, Kankana with Futi Cha. All these things have to come back. This is our food. So it's basically transfer of knowledge.
In terms of sustainability, I mean, it's amazing how you build these ideas and get the villagers to buy in and actually sustain and build a festival. But in terms of sustainability, is it possible to carry on with it, to spread the idea?
Yeah, so basically now we've reached about 35 soon, once at the end of the year. So the future basically will be festivals which are people funded. Yeah, so this idea in Europe is working. So you have a people funded festival where the simplest idea, you would put a box and people would come, eat, enjoy, and then know if you put money for that, if you put some money in that box, the organizers will be able to create another festival next year. And there are a lot of like-minded people now who want this festival to survive and are backing the festivals. So from now onwards, it is going to happen, because this is all our next few festivals will be like that, where it will be crowdfunded, is the new term around the world. So with crowdfunding, it's an easy festival to survive.
What was the most difficult part of all this?
No, it's basically to sell the first. I don't do festivals, I'm not invited. So once few people invite me, two, three people, then I tell them, you arrange 10, 20 people from your village who are sort of like-minded. And the first thing that I tell them, the festival will have no money. So that's when, you know, there's a bit of silence and you create a festival with no money. And then we talk. And basically I would say, okay, I'm going to give the potatoes. Are you going to give onions, tomatoes? Oh, yeah, okay, yes, done. And there are a lot of people who can't even give you that. But can they cut the potatoes? Can they cut the onions? Yes. And some people can't do that, but they got skills of music. So they'll train the musician. Then there's some who can train you singing. Groups are ready. Food is ready. Then there's some people who can't do that. They can serve. So we need people to serve. And then there's some people who can't even do that, but they can collect the garbage. So you've got all these people in your villages, and highly skilled people in the villages. So we get them all together, and a word of mouth festival basically it is. And yeah, you get the villages. Sukkur is now an example of like 7 years festival is going on, with up to 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 people being fed for free. Carmona, huge amount of people coming. Recently, even Arambol, a fishing festival was done. There it reached a stage where we finished really atrocious conditions, but a festival that people like. But the end of the festival was the kind people of Arambol offered the fish. So people only had to bring their bags and take as much fish as they wanted home. So this is what Goenkar Pond
is. It's like the miracle of bread and fish.
That's
in
what
that
people
sense.
Have said. But this is basically us. Goans are like that. Hindu Goans, Catholic Goans, we are like that. So, I mean, and there are things that binds us. So when you say Patoyanche Fest, that binds a Catholic and a Hindu. They come for your festival because that is their food. That is their sweet. You talk about gumot. That is our instrument. The Catholics, the Hindus, all caste, religion, they won't think. That gumot pulls them. So that is one of the successes. And all our festivals now, these things are going to be included. The gumot. Patoyas during season. So basically all our festivals are seasonal. So let's say we start in February would be the Gumot festival. March would be the Kazunche fest. April would be the Ambianche fest. And then in May we have like a picnic festival. June is Ponsache fest, seasonal.
Saligaon.
Yeah, and then we have one in Saligaon which is called Vangon de Saligaon. July, too much rain. August, then we have Patoyanche fest in Sukkur. And then we have a quarter of this in Carmona on the same day. Then September you have the Poderanche Fest, two festivals, and then Zaranso Fest as well. In October we go for the Rampondkaranche Fest, and so on. Whole year round there are festivals happening in different parts of Goa.
Fantastic, and thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Anyway, we are hoping that, you know, thanks to you, a lot of these messages have gone around the world, and we need social media to play a greater role, because presently I get messages from all around the world saying, oh, I've seen this festival and that festival. So the media has played a huge role in the last 10 years, 15 years. And
everyone
we need that.
Has contributed, yes.
We need that to continue.
Thank you.